Hello Mayors, Buildit with Smith here, with hopefully what will be a helpful video that will help you make Simoleons Fasters in your shops. So what I'm going to do in this video is basically go through each one of the stores and tell you which item or items, no more than two, try to keep it to one, but which items you should be producing and selling in the Global Trade Headquarters every day to make the maximum amount of Simoleons, and that will get you well on your way to making a pretty good profit per day. If you're into that. So we've got nine here. The building store, the hardware store, the farmer's market, the furniture store, the garden supplies, donut shop, fashion store, the fast food restaurant, and the home appliances. All right, Mayors, I wanted to share this resource that I will reference in this video. I found it over at fandom.com. You can go there too at simcity.fandom, and here it's going to show you a list of items in SimCity Buildit. So we'll scroll right through. That shows the raw material that we really are not paying attention to in this video, but here is what we want to see. So this chart right here is very informational, and it gives us information about what levels you have to unlock in order to make these items in the stores. It shows you the max value that you can sell them for in the Global Trade Headquarters, shows you the minimum amount of time that it will take to make them, the material, the maximum cost to make, and the profit, and the simoleons per minute, which I thought is an interesting metric that they set. And here, this is pretty useful. It shows you which items in further shops use these actual tools here. So I will be referencing this in this video, and I will also have it linked down below in the comments. All right, let's get back. Also, at the end of this video, I'll give you five tips that will help you as well be productive with your shops. So the first building we have here is the building store. If you're a lower level player, I'm going to give you two suggestions, right? If you're a lower level player, I would say use the building store to make nails and bricks all day, sell them in the Global Trade Headquarters. The metal, you only need two metal for your nails, and they're really quick to produce. I think like 3 minutes or something like that, and it's 30 seconds. Or is it? No, it's a minute for the metal. So really quickly there, you're going to have lots of nails that you can sell at a very high production rate and profit yield, I guess you could say. And then bricks. Now, bricks take a little bit longer to make, but again, that's something that you can make at the lower levels, and it'll keep you stacking simoleons little bit by bit. Now, for the higher level players, I would say only use this store for making material that you can use in other recipes later down the line in some of the other shops that you can use to make items to sell for more profit. That's what I'm trying to say. Next up, you have the hardware shop. Here you're going to make a lot of shovels and a lot of measuring tape. You will see, you will find that a lot of the recipes, especially in some of the stores like let's see, the furniture shop here, the garden supply, the fashion store. They use a lot of measuring tape, and the farmer's market also will use a lot of shovels for trees and things like that. And so I would say make shovels, make measuring tape, save them, don't sell them, save them so that you can use them in other recipes later down the line. It's just like with the building store. Farmer market. I'm going to make it really easy for you guys. Just make flour bags. Flour bags. Just uses textiles, which you produce in your factory, and seeds, and I think two seeds, one textile, something like that. I think that's the recipe. I don't have it on my iPad right now, but that's what I think that you should use. Flour bags, sell them all day, save some, sell the rest. You'll need some to make, you know, other recipes and things like that, like we talked about, but flour bags is going to be your go-to item at the farmer's market. The furniture store. I will encourage you to make chairs and make home textiles. Now, home textiles are one of those things that sell for a pretty good high profit. Again, they use the measuring tape, so that's one of the ways that you could use that. The chairs, on the other hand, I think they use hammers, nails, and not that much stuff. The stuff doesn't take that long to produce that you'll need for that. So chairs, home textiles, sell those home textiles and sell those chairs in the global trade headquarters. Now the garden supply shop. Two things I would suggest for you to sell in the garden supply shop is the grass and the garden furniture. Garden furniture, again, is going to use the textiles, so you want to keep some textiles, a lot of textiles. You want to constantly keep producing those in your factory. By the way, if you don't know what you should be producing in your factory video, take a look up my left, your right, one of those places. Click on that video and watch it right after this one so you can know what you should be producing in your factories. All right, now we're at the donut shop, and we don't want to complicate things too much, so I'm just going to say make donuts at the donut shop. Make them all day. They're going to use flour bags and sugar. Make the donuts all day. They yield a very good profit, as you can see. The fashion store. I would just keep it simple again in the fashion store and just make caps. Now you can make shoes, but that's going to use glue. Glue takes a little while to produce, but you can make shoes or caps, whatever you prefer. I personally make caps because I think it's a little bit easier, but that's just me. Okay, the fast food restaurant. Now here's where you want to really start to kind of make sure that you are utilizing your time wisely while in the game. And so a lot of people for a long time had thought that hamburgers were the best thing to sell. Now, me, Buildit with Smith, I will tell you ice cream sandwiches is a good thing, especially if you're medium level. I know I saw a lot of that when I was in the 30, 40 range or something, a lot of ice cream being sold. And it only took, I believe, 16 minutes to sell. Now, if you really want to make some profit, and if you're able to find the watermelons in the Global Trade Headquarters, I would say make lemonade bottles. Lemonade bottles can yield a big profit, but like I said, it calls for a watermelon in there, and as you know, watermelons are several steps. You got to make the shovel for the tree, then you got to make the watermelon, then, you know, it's a long process. So unless you can't find the watermelon itself in the Global Trade Headquarters, I would say don't make the lemonade bottles unless you have the watermelons. And home appliance shop is the last shop. We're going to keep it easy. We're going to keep it simple. And I will just suggest to you to make TVs all day. TVs do not take a long time. They do not take a lot of material that you have to make and other parts of the thing. So I would just say to do that. Now, if you stuck around to the end of the video, you will get 5 tips that I will tell you, and maybe even a bonus tip. So, tip number 1, buy items that take a lot of time to produce. I talked about this when I talked about the lemonade bottles, things like watermelons, things like beef. Beef takes 3 hours. Yes, it only takes 3 animal feed, which is raw material, but if you add up how much time it takes to get those 3 animal feed, which I believe is like there's 6 hours per, so that's a long time just for 3 of those. Then you have to sit and wait for it to make the beef. So certain things that you know takes a lot of time uses things like animal feed, uses things like sugar, you know, raw products that take a long time to produce, and then those take a long time to produce other products. Hopefully I'm making sense, but there are a few things, and you kind of be the judge. I would say watermelons. I would say green smoothies, which actually you don't need green smoothies in anything. Maybe cheese, beef, bread rolls, things like that. Glue, if you find it. Those certain things can help to speed the process along because time is money. So that is my first suggestion. My first tip to you. And tip number 2 is don't sell key material for recipes. Like, key material, in my opinion, would be textiles. Chemicals. These are both 2 things that are used very, very much in all of your stores. So don't sell those once you produce them in your factories. Hold on to them. Use them for recipes in the building shop. Tip number 3. Something you got to pay attention to, guys. Max sell does not equal max profit. What I mean by that is you may have something like the hamburgers, for instance. They sell for a maximum, they sell for a high price, but that doesn't necessarily mean that you're going to get a high profit off of that. Looking back at our chart here, you can see the comparison and the things that go into what makes something high profit. You're taking the time that it takes into consideration. You're taking the material that it makes into consideration, all those sorts of things. So just because something may sell for a high cost in the global trade headquarters doesn't mean that that's what you should be spending your time on doing if you want to make money quick, Simoleons that is, in SimCity Buildit. And that kind of gives me into tip four, which I kind of guess I told you already. Take production time into consideration. Use this map here, and I put the link in there already. Should be in the description below in the video. This is a very good map that they put together to kind of help to break down the time that is going into all these items, from the raw material in the factories to whatever material you may have to make in like the building store or the hardware store or the farmer's market. Take that material and move it up to like the fast food restaurant or the fashion store. All that time is going to give you the total time here, and so pay attention to that. And the last thing I will say is speed up tokens. Use them, but use them wisely. And of course, you get your speed up tokens once you produce epic buildings. Epic buildings can produce one of three. Oh, excuse me. Epic buildings can produce one of three speed up tokens. You have your llamas, you have your you have your turtles, you have your llamas, and you have your cheetahs. So use them wisely. Kind of, you know, use good judgment. Don't use them all. Sometimes they're not necessary. I usually like to save mine for if I'm in a contest of mayors or something like that, where I'm trying to work up in the ranks for something. They're not all, you know, and so maybe use one per session, one a day per store per session. I wouldn't just use multiple ones every time you close out the game, because then you'll be broke and poor. All right. And there was one last thing I was going to point out in my videos. Throughout the game, you're able to upgrade your stores, which means you can increase the time that they take to produce. So you may see in my stores where something takes a lot lesser time than it takes in your stores. So pay attention to that. Pay attention and upgrade your stores when you get the prompt to, because that's going to move your production along too. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I've been Buildit with Smith here. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. And also, I want to send a shout out to everyone in India who has been coming through to SimCity Buildit, supporting the channel. I see you guys in the comments all the time, and I appreciate your support. Well, that's it for now. I'll see you guys later. Peace out.